Sujit sir, I think
I
custom
think we
format.
have done just conditional, conditional formatting, just partially we had done. And after that, I think Sujit has sent me a couple of videos just to go through.
Okay.
But I think you can start with where Murli has left, so that we can, if anything is repetition, nothing like that.
Yes. So we were doing some formulas, because after that we will be repeating some conditional formatting project where your doubts regarding conditional formatting will be clear. So we need some formula power to create that project. So firstly, I will let you know some important formulas. So Murli sir, are we done with this? And false, if, I
No,
think
no, no. No, we
so
haven't done that.
okay. So let me start with logical formulas. This is our first class regarding formulas. That was the introduction of formulas, that how we start formula, but it is we are starting our formula. The first function we have, which we very well known about, if formula. If we have to done some logical calculations, what we do in logical calculation, we check greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, or not equal to. These operators, we do some calculations here, such as I am checking that is 20 greater than 10, the result will display in true or false. True or false, that is called Boolean value in programming language. We have lot of values here, such as we can enter numbers, we can enter text something. Likewise, we have Boolean values such as true and false. In true and false, it is also denoted as 1 and 0. You might have seen in some electronic systems written as 0, 1. 1 means on, 0 means off. And the computer also works on that binary system. The all binary system is based upon this 0, 1. So here, just a reference, it is given here as a Boolean value. So Boolean value help us to analyze value with logical operators, to check the values logically, whether it is greater than, it is equal to, it is less than equal to, it is not equal to. It always gives result in true and false. So logical formulas helps you to work on logical conditions. So our first function is if, that works on Boolean value. Suppose that we type an if condition for that, for this equation. We want to check, this is our first number and second number. We want to check whether our first number is greater than second number or not. We have checked through this logical condition greater than, and we result it to with if formula. The first parameter is logical test, which we have done here. We can give reference from here. On the basis of the result, we have two parameters here, value if true and value if false. the value will be the these parameters will be separated by comma. So we will put comma here, and in this formula we have to provide if the value returns true. So what should it display? I will display first number is greater. When we enter some text or alphanumeric value, so we always enter in these inverted commas. But if we want to display numbers, we can directly mention numbers here. But here I want to give the text, so I am using inverted commas. In value of true parameter, I will provide that value when the result becomes false, it will display this parameter, the value if false. I will display here second number is greater. Now we have applied if formula. Here you can see the first number is greater, but if we do this second number greater, then the logical condition will return false and our if formula will return you the value if false part. So the value will be displayed here. You understand that?
Yeah, I think it's clear. I think in place of first number is greater or second number is greater, we can put any value also, right?
Yes.
Just to identify whether A is greater or B is greater.
Yes.
Anything we can put, but it should be in inverted commas. That's it, right?
Yes. If you are providing text, it should be in inverted commas. If you are providing numbers, you can you need not to mention that inverted commas. Okay.
Okay.
So if formula is used for create better access to the result, your customized result here. And there are some other formulas also. After if, you have or, not, and, three functions. Suppose that you have gone for an interview and there was some rounds, first round, second round, and third round. The candidate names who appeared for interview are these. Now the result has been given in yes or no. What is this yes or no? Three judges have taken different rounds and given their marks for your selection, that it is okay for second judge, whether you have cleared or not that round. This information is all about that. So there are three conditions in round. Now we have to display the result. We have a condition. If the person has cleared three rounds, then only he will be selected. Okay. So how we will build that? If we do through if formula, then we have to check that our first reference is greater than is equal to yes or not. And if it is yes, then only it should go in value if true. Then we put again if formula and check that if it is yes or not. If it is yes, we again check other value. It is equal to yes or not. Otherwise, we will provide failed. Otherwise, failed.
And if we just put if y is equal to 3, that we can also put?
Equal to 3, why me?
If number of y's are 3, it means he is selected, right?
Yes,
if we shorten
yes,
the form.
Yes.
And how that would look like? I think, okay, let you can finish, then if you could tell us would be great, yeah. That if y is equal to 3, then he is also selected. If it is less than 3, he is rejected.
Yes, it is like that, but in different cell, it is somewhere impossible to calculate in a single formula.
Okay.
So that's why we are putting if for everything. Oh, we have not done for pass, we have not left any option.
Yeah, we have passed for VN1.
So
yeah.
Here in our last section, here we have to mention that past,
okay. Pass and else it is failed, right? Automatically.
Yes.
So once you put it in the formula, suppose if B6 is Y, C6 is Y, D6 is Y, is pass, and we need not write else. Yes, it is automatically whatever will be the next text in commas, it will be considered as other option.
Yes, if we come to here, it will finally check that and go to value if true or value if false. If it is y,
okay,
then only it will go. And if it is not y at any level, it automatically goes to fail. Here it will come only if these values are becoming true.
And okay. What is after this failed? Suppose if B6 is Y, C6 is Y, D6 is Y, he is passed, else he is failed, right? And after that again twice we have written failed. What does it signify?
It signifies that, sir, you can see every one of the example. We can evaluate from our formula. We evaluate every formula. Let's see how it works. In this formula, it has checked B6 first. Is it Y
right
or not? Evaluate.
Right.
True. We have entered into true that it is checking Y again. False. If where it is false, then it will not run this code. It will directly jump to this one.
Okay.
Evaluate, failed. Likewise.
Okay, so even if at second stage or first stage he considered it as false, and immediately it will show as failed, right?
Yes. In this section, it will fail in our first round. Here it is N. False. It will jump there and failed directly.
Okay.
So it is a long procedure and difficult to understand. Because we are writing too much long formula for that. But we have an AND operator here. Let us simplify these conditions. Equal to y. So there are immediate true false values. Okay. We have AND formula we can put lot of condition in our single formula, and it will return true when only all the values are true. Okay, it is the power of, it is the working of AND. You have checked at every level that is it equal to y or not. The true false result is given here for these statements, these results, and where all the values are true, then only it will show true, otherwise it will show false.
So what does AND means?
AND means,
what does AND?
AND means you can put lot of logical conditions there, but when all the result will be true, then only it will return you true in a single statement.
Okay. So only AND will only take care of all trues.
Correct.
Like this, or all false also?
No,
only trues.
Only trues. Okay. So here we have typed too much long formula, and here we have combined in a single AND statement, and now we can use an IF formula and take reference of this AND and put our result here as pass and fail. Correct.
Just repeat what we have done.
I've just taken the reference in the logical test from AND, the result from AND.
Okay, if i6, how to read it? If i6 is
basically
false.
Yes. The logical test, when it will return true, then it will go to here, the value of true section, and when it will return false, it will go value in false section. Okay, so whenever it will find true, then only it will show the true result. The formula work like that, but the secret working here is about AND formula, how it is working.
Okay,
let's see another example of OR formula, and let's change our conditions here. If we put OR formula and take a reference of all of these, here we put. So the difference between AND and OR formula is, OR will return true if only a single value returns true. There can be lot of false, but if a single value returns you true, then OR will display you true.
Okay, even if one value is out of n number of rows or columns, even if one is found to be true,
yes,
then it will write as true, right?
Correct. So let us change our condition here. First, we have done that a candidate should pass all the rounds, but
in one just a moment, Sir Sandeep, here in OR, where we have written this formula that if any of the values is true, then it should show as true. Where we have written this? In the formula itself. What does it mean? It is OR. Just a moment. F6, G6, H6. Now, how we should read this formula? We should read it like OR.
See.
Either of these.
First, see. Here we have done logical evaluation. For the logical evaluation, we have used in AND and OR formula. The logical operator itself returns true and false, and the AND formula returns if all the values are true, then only it will show you true. OR formula, when a single value becomes true, it will return you true. These are the basic difference.
We should just remember these things, right? If it is AND, yes, it means all the value. If it is OR, either one of the value. Like
correct.
That we should remember, right?
Correct. And let us understand in a single statement that if a candidate need to be selected, he has to clear all the rounds. So we will do done through AND formula. We will do it through AND formula. But
yeah, correct.
We want that anyone who have cleared a single round can be selected, then we can use OR formula.
Exactly, yeah, that's right. Now understood, yeah.
So if formula is just a supporting here, so we can take the reference here and write whatever we want to write, value if true and value if false. Pass and fail. Now I have broken the formula in different cells. Now I want to create a single formula through them. How I will write in single formula? In my AND condition, my formula will be started with if, and the evaluation will be done as here. The three logical condition I can put in a single AND formula. And
how many logical conditions we can put it, Sandeep?
N numbers of.
N number, okay. Okay.
In only AND and OR function. And if you can use only one single logical calculation in a single time. Okay, so we will write as pass and fail. We don't have to repeat every time this pass fail statement. What we have done here, logical and logical test. Okay, here, and we, if you want to use OR formula, we will type as if OR equal to yes, equal to y, and this one equal to y. In single statement we will decide pass and fail. Okay, so this is all about AND, OR, and IF function. Do you understand that what I mean to say?
So the it means if all the values are yes, yes, then it is pass, else fail. And in OR, it is if one value is yes, then it is pass, else fail. Right? Even if one value is Y. Right?
Yes.
In OR.
Yes. Exactly. So that's how the if, else, if, and OR formula works. Now let's move to another function. We have a logical operator like not, we use in many time, such as we use this value is not equal to this value. This greater than and less than sign we use combinedly for not equal to statement. We have a function. If we want to know that if this equal to this or not, we can just put equal to statement here. And if we use in our not formula, this equal to this, it will reverse the result, like not equal to, not greater than, not greater than equal to. Okay, so this one and this one result will be same. In short, this will reverse your result of true false. Got it, sir?
Yeah.
You can give the true, you have two functions in logical formulas, true and false. It returns true and false as well. Okay, it does not do anything, it just returns the value is true, value as false. Next you have if error formula and logical, like if formula, it is conditioned to work where the error occurs, such as we have a formula for error. You might have seen these this type of errors in VLOOKUP function and many functions. It is only for errors. If you write this formula, if error, give the reference here, and you have another option, value if error. If the error occurs, then what it would do? So we can provide our statement and we can put as blank here. So if it is not error, it will not show you anything. And if it is error, then it will display the result what we have given in value if error section. It works like if statement. With if, how we will evaluate that is error function we have. Is error, here we have checked is error, then in true section we can use anything, another we are giving blank. In spite of writing this long formula, we have a separate formula here, if error. Okay. Got it, sir?
And how we consider this is an error or not an error? Just this sign which we are seeing as not applicable kind of stuff, he thinks it is an error?
There are different types of errors in our Excel. If you want to know the error types.
Yeah.
Errors in Excel. Formula errors. So you have this kind of error. This name error, value error. There are a lot of types of error, divisible by zero error, reference error.
Okay, if any of these falls there, then automatically it will consider that as an error and give it as whatever we want, as mistake or whatever we put the text in, that will give us. Okay.
While doing automation, we don't like ourselves to be display these types of error. So we usually replace by these inverted commas as a blank. We don't want to show the errors. So we do like this way. So it will not display anything if there is an
actually
error.
Actually, it is an error, right?
Yes, yes.
But actually, it is an error. Okay.
Yes, yes. Okay, so that's how we use these logical formulas. Now let's move to text formula. In our text formula, the first formula is bart text. Bart text, what is this? It is the first formula I have learned in text, but it was quite confusing that time. When I give the cell reference or type and number, it displays some this kind of another language. I just copied that language and gone to Google Translate option. And when I paste it, I had found that it is converting numbers into words, but in Thai language. So there is no use for us just for knowledge sake. We must know about this first function.
What is that language actually?
Thai language.
Thai language, okay.
Baht is actually a currency of Thailand.
Ah, okay, okay.
So it is written in Thai language, but why in Thai language, I do not understand that.
Okay.
Maybe they have given some bribe to them. Let's find another function. There we have char and code. Next function we have char and code. These two functions are very interesting in Excel, in text function. Do you know about ASCII values, ASCII codes? These are American standard of codes for computer. If you type ASCII in Google, you'll find ASCII table. Actually, they have designed some code for every letter, such as you can find capital A in 65, the code is 65, the decimal code for A is 65, and for small a it is 97. So there is a code for every character. So once a student has asked me, you can drag the numbers in Excel, but you can't drag ABCD. You can't drag that. How you will drag that? He has asked me this question. What I have done that, I have typed A here, and with the help of code function, I found the code of this a, and then in this code I have plus 1. I have done plus 1, and again I have converted this code into character with the help of char function. So we have two functions here. For knowing the code, we use code function. If we have code, for knowing the character, we use char function. So by adding 1 into the code of A, I had found B. So in a single formula, I have typed char code this one plus 1 in bracket close. This formula I have typed and dragged it, and now it was working. You might have seen while using Excel, if you have to go to another line into a single cell, you use wrap text or you use alt enter for typing in another line in same cell. So this alt enter also has a code. I type here only alt enter. So it has a code and it is 10. In 10 you can find out new line. For new line there is a code here. So if I have to merge two values with this alt enter option, how will I do that? I will take this reference, I concatenate this, first I concatenate this one, both of the values. This AND operator concatenates both the values in single cell, but I have used ALT ENTER, so I can concatenate the code 10 here and again concatenate for doing the same.
Can you repeat again, sir?
Char 10, actually. Char 10. 10 is the code and the character I want to give. It is there. And when I'll do wrap text, it will show me like these. This. Now automatic generation. Automatic generation of this. Alt enter. So how I have used that? You have another function here, a repeat. Suppose that I type some random values between 1 to 10. And I applied repeat function. You have seen bar charts in conditional formatting. So the text I want to repeat is through repeat function is like star or @ any of the character, and how many types at times I want to repeat, I can choose reference from here. So it is showing me like a chart. I just replace this character. Instead of @, I use this. There is a character upon backslash. It is this one. I don't know what we call this character, but when you apply it, and I show you on my on screen keyboard, the character is this one. So it is looking like somewhere chart. And for merging these, I use different font where it look like merge Britannic bold. So it look like some chart options. I just select the different color for the font and it is looking like a chart, like data bars. If I select and apply data bars here, it will be same like that. So we can, with the help of repeat formula, REPT formula, we can show the effect of chart here. But likewise, here I have used this for single chart. But suppose I have two datas. Now I want to use double charts. In the other one, I will concatenate this thing with code char10. What it will do, it will create a single line, and instead of H7, I will choose different data from here. And when I do wrap text here, it is showing me double chart. Okay, for different values.
Can you please read this formula? How we should read this formula?
Equal to REPT and this. In inverted commas, I have provided that text which is to be repeated and the number of times to be repeated. Numbers of times I have taken reference from this cell. In other function, I have taken reference from this cell. In between, I have put that code 10, the 10th character, new line. So it is creating a line here after one chart, after repetition of one character, one cell character. So it is showing you the bar effect, the bar chart effect here. Okay. And if you align them to 90 degrees, it will look like column chart. It is looking like column chart. 6 and 1, we type 10. So it is looking like chart here. But this chart has an specialty. Suppose if you know VLOOKUP function, this chart is the only chart that can be called through VLOOKUP function. Suppose we want to call the, we type some values here. So VLOOKUP, we can call this chart. I will tell you, we look up formula later if you don't know about this formula. And we copy the formats from here. I just fix the value. If you change the ID from here, the chart will change automatically. For dashboarding, we use these types of formula and charting concepts. So, hope you understand that. If you not, just practice that. We will move to rest of the formula tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. But where it is used?
In dashboards. I'm just giving you the reference of that, how can we use the formulas. But after completion of this formula, I will provide you some assignments for practicing all these functions.
Yeah.
I'm just creating a reference for you that how can we use these formulas. Okay, sir.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I just couldn't find this virtual keyboard here in my accessories. Could you please check, Sandeep?
What you have? What window you have?
10.
Window. 2007 or what? Windows 8.
Windows
7.
Windows XP. Yeah.
XP.
XP should be, yeah.
So in
accessories, could you please check accessories? I can see, but I don't see that virtual keyboard.
You just press this window keyboard and press the R button equal. So you will find this run command there, and you can type OSK for on screen keyboard. I don't know that
okay.
Whether it is available in XP or not. But you can find.
Okay, run and then OSK, right?
Yes. That means on screen keyboard.
Let me try. OSK.
You can check in on Excel. OSK in XP. Yes.
Sandeep ji, one small question here.
Yes.
Actually, today I have one small requirement came to me.
Mm-hmm.
I just created used different sheets in one Excel.
Okay.
Okay, and created some formulas in one sheet.
Okay.
And the same formulas I want to copy to the other book. It is taking this book references actually to there.
Yes.
So I want to avoid that. Actually, suppose a sheet 1, 2, 3 here in this book,
okay.
This workbook, and the same formulas which I created in the sheet 3 should be copied to the other sheets, other workbook also. So when I do that, what happened is it is just copying with the it is make it as a fixed thing.
Okay.
Paste formulas.
Yes, you can use this paste formula function, the same formula you will find here without the sheet reference.
Yeah, it is coming to no, it is make from the that workbook, not the sheet actually.
Have you used that paste special formula?
Paste special formula, yes. See, in this worksheet, suppose say worksheet 1, 2, 3, you have some figures.
Yes.
And sheet 3,
mm-hmm.
Sheet 3, I am linked 1, 2, 3 sheets.
Okay.
And I will go to the other workbook, and other workbook also 1, 2, 3 sheets are there.
Mm.
And I want to copy these formulas of sheet 3 in the first workbook to the other sheet. It is taking the data from, it is giving the reference of the first workbook.
Okay. Let me try here. Suppose
yeah.
I am using.
You have the sheet 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
Yes. So in sheet.
You put one figure in. Yeah. You put one figure in. Yeah. Here. 16th row. Okay. One figure.
From here. And now.
You put number. I mean, it's not. No need of so complicated one. Just give one number.
Just this one. Okay. Now I copy this and paste.
Do another workbook, yeah.
Okay. Yes, it is another workbook. So.
Yeah, it is taking the reference of workbook one. I don't want the workbook one reference actually, but I want this formula.
Yes, it is taking the reference. So you can use that find replace function here. What
find and
replace.
Okay, you mean to say wherever the workbook is there that we can replace. Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Just copy this thing.
Or otherwise, when I do create this formula in the one workbook, I have to record the macro and.
No. Just it will be done through this one. Replace with nothing, replace all.
Okay. Yeah.
This will work.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Good night.
Good night.